examination. Please do not begin any procedure until the verbal instructions have been given and you're instructed to begin. Step back to indicate that you have finished. Once the candidates have stepped back, the proctor reads, all candidates have indicated that they have completed this section of the examination. We will now proceed. You will perform a basic facial. You'll be expected to follow all client protection, safety, and infection control procedures. You have 20 minutes to complete this section. You will be informed when you have 10 minutes remaining. Step back to indicate that you have finished. The instructions are repeated. The candidate is told, you may begin. In 14.1, the candidates will be evaluated on the following tests, that the supplies are labeled in English. In 14.2, all implements and supplies are visibly clean. In 14.3, the candidates should cleanse the eye area. When working around the eye area, the candidates should demonstrate bracing. In 14.4, the candidates should clean or cleanse the lips. When working around the mouth, the candidate should demonstrate bracing as well. In 14.5, the candidate should cleanser should be distributed evenly across the face. In 14.6, the candidate should remove the cleanser in a consistent manner. In 14.7, the candidate should apply a toner or an astringent safely to assure that it doesn't get in the eye of the client. In 14.8, the candidate must apply an exfoliating product over the face and manipulate it with an implement or material, not to include the eyes or the mouth. The candidate, some candidates sometimes use a small hand brush to manipulate the product or a battery-operated ultrasonic brush. No plug-in ultrasonic brushes will be allowed, only battery-operated ultrasonic brushes. And some candidates also use a sponge to manipulate the product. In 14.9, a steam towel is applied and removed. The candidate should sanitize their hands and then retrieve a damp towel from their simulated hot towel cabinet. They should wring out any excess water and then test the temperature on the wrist or the forearm. Milady says test it on the wrist. Pivot point says test it on the forearm. The candidate then should apply the towel to the face of the client. In 14.10, the candidate should carefully remove the residual product. In 14.11, the candidate is required to distribute massage product over the face completely in a safe manner, not to get the product in the eyes or the mouth. In 14.12, 13, 14, and 15, the candidate should demonstrate the effleurage, petrissage, deployment, and friction. The candidate is required to at least demonstrate four massage manipulations. In 14.16, the candidate should remove the residual massage product. In 14.17, a toner or an astringent should be applied. In 14.18, the candidate must apply a moisturizer. And in 14.19, all items to be disinfected, soil, linens, and trash should always be disposed of in the correct manner throughout the section. Once the candidates have completed this, the proctor reads, all candidates have indicated that they have completed this section of the examination. We will now proceed. And now I'm going to go to the sculptured nail as an additional service for cosmetology. The proctor reads to your candidates. You have 2 minutes to set up the supplies for the sculpture nail section of this examination. Please do not begin any procedures until the verbal instructions have been read and you're instructed to begin. Turn the hand toward the examiner to indicate that you have finished. The instructions are repeated. The candidates are told, you may begin. Once the 2 minutes have expired, the candidates have demonstrated that they have completed this section. The proctor reads, all candidates have indicated that they have completed this section, please do nothing until the next verbal instructions are given. You will sculpt a nail on the assigned finger. You must use a manufactured sealed, low odor, less odor product. You will be expected to follow all client protection, safety, and infection control procedures. You have 20 minutes to complete this section. You will be informed that you have 10 minutes remaining. Turn the hand toward the examiner to indicate you have finished. In 20.1, the candidate must set up the sculptured nail supplies to include polymer and monomer. Again, the monomer should be factory sealed, no MMA products. In 20.2, implements and supplies should be visibly clean. In 20.3, the candidate should remove the shine from the nail plate. And in 20.4, the candidate is required to cleanse and dehydrate the nail plate. In 20.5, the candidate must have created a free edge on the hand prior to coming to the exam. In 20.6, the candidate applies nail primer to the nail plate. In 20.7, the candidate sculpts a nail to extend the free edge of the assigned finger. In 20.8, in shaping and contouring the nail, the candidate must not create divots or grooves in the nail. The free edge of the sculpted nail should be smooth and should blend seamlessly with the natural nail. When fouling, the candidate must have at least one finger at the sidewall. In 20.9, the examiner is looking to evaluate the final appearance of the nail. The examiner will evaluate the nail and check for smoothness, balance, and evenness. In 20.10, the examiner checks the surrounding skin to make sure that the cuticle is free from damage and the skin surrounding is free from damage. Once each candidate has been individually evaluated, the examiner will give these instructions to please do nothing until the further instructions are given. Once all of the candidates have been evaluated, the proctor reads, all examiners have indicated that they're ready to proceed. Now we're going to go over the questions that were submitted for cosmetology. The first question from the school owners and instructors, do a candidate have to sanitize their hands every time they throw things away, even if they don't touch the trash? No. Only if the hands come in contact with the trash, items to be disinfected, or soiled linens. That's the only time that they need to re-sanitize their hands. Only if they come in contact with those areas, the trash, items to be disinfected, and soiled linens. The next question would be, is the bag with the steam towel inside viewed as a hot towel caddy? Should it be kept during the exfoliation procedure on the universal station as a result? The answer is yes. Are client bags to be combined with all services for client one and client two to be in separate bags and no longer I'm gonna read that over. Are client bags to be combined with all services for client one and client two to be in separate bags and no longer in separate bags? Yes, we're expecting your candidate to have a client one bag with all of the supplies and things that they need in that client one bag for that first portion of the exam. Once they come to the new client portion of the exam, they would retrieve their client two bag. And again, every and all should be placed within that client two bag. For additional services, the candidate could have separate bags. For example, for the sculptured nail, they could have a separate bag labeled sculptured nail. And then for the basic facial, they could have a separate bag for that as well. EPA registered wipes have been difficult to obtain. Now with the COVID-19 rise in cases, we have concerns with the availability for testing. What is the suggestion if these are not available prior to testing? Again, the candidates, as I stated within the exam, they're able to simulate this with an approved downloaded label from an EPA registered disinfectant. Again, the candidate could go and retrieve baby wipes. They could use a large Ziploc bag to place those in. The candidate can go to, for example, Barberside and download their label for Barberside wipes and attach that label to the container that's holding the baby wipes. This would constitute as a simulated disinfecting wipe that would be approved for the exam. Should additional services be in separate bags or all in the second claim bag and set up at the same time? Again, the additional services should be in separate bags. For example, the sculpture nail should be in a sculpture nail bag, labeled sculpture nail, and the basic facial should be in a separate bag as well, labeled basic facial. Are towels allowed to be placed in each client bag? This is something that you probably would teach your candidate, so the answer to that would be yes. When cosmetologists are doing domain 5, which is your chemical waving, are they allowed to section the hair into 6 sections into a mohawk When cosmetologists are doing domain 5, which is your chemical waving, are they allowed to section the hair into 6 sections to do the back mohawk crown to make? Wrapping. And the answer to that is yes. This is a form of technique that you all may teach your candidates, and we don't score the candidates on technique. However they achieve that will be up to the candidate. And then the last question is, for client 2, it states in the instructions to set up for the remainder of the examination. My question to you is that do they set up all chemical services on the side working table, like the perm, highlight, et cetera? Or do they simply place the remainder of the section, perm, highlight, et cetera, on the supply table and simply set up as you complete each section of the exam one at a time? I strongly suggest that all of the products and all of the implements and tools that they're going to use be placed out where the examiner can evaluate them to make sure that all is written in English and that the items show that they're visibly clean. And at the time that they're required to do a task, the candidate will then set those items up to perform that task. It will be given time in the instructions to do just that. I'm going to now go from this over to Barbara Stallings.